I'm far from home. I'd better get back before Sir Radzig sends out a search party.
Hail the conquering hero.
Wouldn't you like to take a stroll somewhere?
I'd love to.
Listen, Teresa. There's something I ought to tell you.
What is it? What's troubling you?
I'm not quite sure how to tell you, so I'll just spit it out. Sir Radzig Cobbler is... my father.
And King Wenceslas is my cousin. Oh, you really had me going.
No, I'm serious.
What? But, Henry, how on earth could...
I know, it was a shock for me too. It turns out Sir Radzig and my mother had some... romance. Of course, he couldn't marry a commoner.
And your father? I mean, the blacksmith. God... that sounds so odd. I mean Martin.
He knew Sir Radzig from way back. Martin... Pa married her before I was born. To protect her reputation. And raise me as his own.
And Sir Radzig allowed it?
Sure. Actually, I get a feeling the whole thing was agreed between them. Sir Radzig was glad she wasn't left alone with a child.
My God, Henry. That's just... and what will that mean for you?
I honestly don't know.
You don't know?
Well, it all depends on Sir Radzig, doesn't it? That's his illegitimate son. I don't have any rights as such. But it's not like I've suddenly become a noble like Capon. And even though Sir Radzig has publicly acknowledged me, well, sort of, it hasn't really changed anything.
And if Sir Radzig decided to make a real noble of you, would you want that?
I wouldn't. And it's never going to happen anyway.
Why not?
A bastard remains a bastard. Even if Sir Radzig never had another heir, all his property would go to the king by rights.
You might be right, but can't you imagine it? Would you still care for me, a common mill maid, if you were a nobleman?
Of course. I'll always be fond of you. Nothing will change that.
I'll remember that. I hope you won't regret those words.
No fear of that.
Home already? See you another time then.